bringing back memories. 63, they beat Cincinnati to win the NCAA championship in overtime in Louisville, 60-58. Seven black starters in that game. Four on Loyola, including from Harlem, Jerry Harkness. Averaged 21 a game. We get a chance to say hello. Jerry, nice to talk. Christopher Russo, how are you today? Okay?
Hey, this is a pleasure. I'm really impressed. I got the mantle.
So how about that, Jerry? Nice to have you with us.
Chris.
How you doing?
Oh, pleasure.
Nice.
I'm doing good.
Nice to have you with us. You played at Harlem. Tell them the story about Jackie Robinson there, Jer. When Jackie saw you play at Harlem. That's a good story. Go start there first. Go ahead.
Yeah, okay. When I was, I'm from Harlem, and we used to play at the Harlem YMCA, the CYO, all through Harlem. I enjoyed playing at the Y. So I was shooting around one day, and a guy tapped me on my shoulder. And I turned around, and he said, "You know, you're not that bad." My eyes buckled down, my mouth opened up, and he gave me a little wink or something to that effect and went on. As a result, because of what he just turned me on and just pushed me with confidence, I went out for my basketball team. I was afraid to go out that I would miss. And I was a senior, and I went out. And went out, I made the team. Then I started, and then we won everything. And then, of course, the rest is history, because I ended up, after a struggle, I ended up at Loyola Chicago. But the guy that encouraged me to go out with those positive words was Jackie Robinson.
How about that?
And, of course, you know, we lived in Harlem, and it's segregated. Most African-Americans would just live there. And you'd run down the street, and you'd see Duke Ellington, Willie Mays, because it was really just segregated. Blacks would be in Harlem. So you would run into all the superstars and the musicians and the poets and all of that. So it wasn't that out of the ordinary for me to run into Jackie Robinson. Later on, he spoke with Don Newcomb and Roy Campanella. And the three of them used to come and say positive words like mentors.
Wow.
So that started my basketball
How
career.
About that? But you probably saw Wilt, right? Chamberlain used to come up to Harlem all the time.
Yes. We used to play at Rucker Park. He would come with a guy named Guy Rogers. All of those guys from Philadelphia would come up to Harlem. Yeah, Wilt Chamberlain used to come up. Oh, we had the best. That in itself was the reason I think I got so good, because I played against the best.
Absolutely. Now, early 60s in New York, Jerry Harkness on that great Loyola team that beat Cincinnati and stopped their three-peat in 63. You've heard a lot about it, of course, this last couple weeks. The early 60s in New York, Jerry, the Knicks were bad. They were not great yet. They had Richie Guerin. They had some players. The baseball with Mantle and Maris. You growing up in Harlem, are you a Knicks fan? Did you like college basketball? What'd you do sports-wise then?
Well,
let me hear.
I really was a huge Brooklyn Dodger. I grew up in Harlem, but I'd love, we would go to Ebbets Field. That was my place. And my best players, the ones that I lived up to early on, my first was Duke Snyder. He was left-handed, I was left-handed. After Duke Snyder, I fell in love. I started playing first base. I fell in love with Gil Hodges.
No kidding.
And then after that, I got older and realized what Jackie Robinson was doing, and then I fell in love with him. So, I liked him. And, of course, Willie Mays was at the Polo Grounds. I could walk to the Polo Grounds from my house.
Really?
And I walk over the bridge, and I'm in Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. So I was right there, and then I'd have to take the subway to Brooklyn.
Wow, how about that? Now, a lot of famous games. Do you remember the 58 championship game, Colts and Giants? That's not too far from where you live. Do you remember that game?
Oh, my goodness. I was I think I was in college at the time. No,
you're about 13.
I was on my way.
Yeah, about 13.
Yeah,
young kid still.
Yes, my goodness. Yeah, I vaguely remember that game. I was I just was a fanatic in Brooklyn Dodger, period. And wasn't into the football as much. And I ran track, so I used to go to Van Cortlandt Park. And matter of fact, track was my number one sport. I was a distance runner and things like that. So with track and field and the basketball, that took a lot. I was a swimmer, too. And Harlem had the pool there. And I was not bad. And the guy that I was close to was John Carlos. You know,
the runner in 68. Oh my gosh, really?
Yes,
wow.
Yes. See, so you're involved in all that, and you find out later on in life that guys that you were hanging around with had made it big in history and all. And so, and then of course, the guy that looked up to me in the project, because I moved from Harlem to the project, was a little bit of, I'm left-handed, and he said this, and he makes me feel so good. But anyway, he said he lived up and he learned from me.
Nate Archibald?
You got it.
I was a guess.
Nate Archibald. You're right. We lived in the project and played like he was coming up, so he was a little younger. I had 6-7 years of. Oh, I think 4 or 5 years old.
And he was one of the great point guards you're ever going to see, Tiny. Went to Texas Western, the whole bit. What made you go, Jerry?
Right.
What made you go to Loyola? How'd you go there? How'd you end up in Chicago?
Well, my grades were horrendous because just playing basketball as a senior and nobody motivated me. I mean, the track was all right, but I didn't have any. Then all of a sudden, my skills improved substantially, but my grades had not. So I had a chance to go to St. John's in track, and then NYU in basketball. But after they saw my grades and I didn't graduate on time, they gave up. Then I went to summer school and graduated and took some extra courses, and Loyola took a chance with me. Wasn't sure, but I had played outdoors against Larry Brown and Doug Moe and Donnie Walsh, and we all played together as a group, Connie Hawkins, Roger Brown, and I got better. And that's when I went to Loyola.
Wow, did you go to that famous high school game? I think it was at the Garden with Roger when Brown played Connie Hawkins. Jerry, were you at that game?
Yeah, I was in college. I was a freshman. But I know that Connie got 18, Roger got 30-something.
Yeah, and Roger Brown, he was a better player than Connie at that point, was he not?
Yes, he was. But Connie came on. Oh, Connie was one of my favorites. Roger, too, because I played with him with the Indiana Pacers. And then Roger and I were so close. And plus, Roger was a high jumper. So we met a lot in track when we'd go around to the different meets. But I was a part of that life. Carl Ramsey, Sat Sanders, and all of Larry Brown, all of that great Doug.
Sure. Absolutely.
That was a great time.
Very good. Roger Brown, of course, went to Iowa, and then he got kicked out because of that disaster. It wasn't his fault with Molinas and the whole thing with the betting and what have you. So you go to Loyola. What'd you know about George Ireland, your head coach? Obviously, he was colorblind, thank God, because he started the four black kids. Give me a little rundown on your head coach there. Let me hear you some thoughts. Go ahead.
Well, rundown, here it goes. He was like 10-12 and 8-12. He was losing. They hung the guy in effigy. So he said, hey, I'm going to lose my job. I got to get some guys in. So that's why he knew about Rucker Park and came to Harlem to try to get some ball players. And also he heard about a black league in Nashville, Tennessee, because blacks couldn't play against whites in Tennessee, even in the in some high schools, but the majority of them, no. So he went there, and then he came to Harlem and recruited me, and he recruited Ron Miller, and then he went to to Nashville, and he just was at the point where he didn't care. He was colorblind, and he took a lot of heat because he'd come late for a meeting, and they say, "Where you been?" In Africa recruiting.
Oh, really?
All of the coaches. Oh, he took a lot of heat. But he said, "Forget you." And he cursed them out and all like that. And he ended up with the national championship.
He did. You know, it's funny. We'll take a quick break with you in a minute to go through that tournament, Jerry. But here's a guy. Look at you. I mean, you had to deal with a lot of racial nonsense, I'm sure. Segregated stuff in Harlem. You go to Loyola. You get all this abuse, I'm sure. Black player in Loyola, yeah. The four players. But you're not bitter at all. You got a hell of a personality. How, Duke Snyder and it wasn't Jackie so much. It was Duke Snyder and Gil Hodges.
Were you
two white kids and for the Dodgers, who are your heroes. How did you stay away? How did you not become bitter here with racial issues in the early 60s? Let me hear.
Well, in the early 60s, I had that's when I'm in school. And I had a lot of some hard feelings. I guess the one thing that really hurt me is that when you got when we had African-Americans in the service, oh, it really hurt me. And they would come home, and they got the story about them coming home on the train, and they had to sit in the back. These are the soldiers. And the Germans could sit wherever they wanted to. Then when they get off, the black soldiers who were bringing these guys as prisoners, they could not go in to eat. But the Germans could.
That's hard to believe. Oh, think about that for a second. Is that true?
Oh my God. And then the Emmett Till thing hit while we were in the projects. So that's the one. And what they did is they put the pictures of Emmett Till in Jet Magazine.
That's the kid.
The black community.
That's the kid. That's the kid in Mississippi who got killed. Correct. Yes.
Yeah.
Famous story.
At 14 years of age, and they said he whistled at one of the white girls, and his mom had told him to be careful down there, be very careful. But they ran over him. They killed all of them. It was awful.
But you overcame
it. I had those ideas, but then. When you're around the Johnny Walshes, when you're around Larry Brown in basketball, it offsets. Because we ran together in basketball together. I mean, black and white played at Rutgers Park. So it offset a lot. But when you personally get involved, then it hurts again.
Great job, Jerry. Hang in there. I got to take a quick break. I want to go to the tournament. Jerry Harkness, okay. Great to have with us from Loyola. We continue here on Mad Dog Unleashed. Don't go away.
This is Down the Stretch.